Hello, welcome back to Weekend Play, Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. This is DrakeLord56, the hero you're better off without. Well, that one weird whoop welcomed us to the next dungeon here. The Arbiter's Grounds. Let's get going, shall we? Not only are we progressing the freaking things here. Get back here. As I was saying, not only are we going to be progressing the story with this particular dungeon, we're also gonna accomplish something as we're going along, and it'll actually occur as we're doing this dungeon here. There we are, that guy's gone. And there's another guy right behind there. Come on, that isn't gonna keep it safe forever. Yep, thought he could get me, huh? Bye! Alright then. To actually get into the actual dungeon, because this is just the... Oh, hi, little guy! So, yeah. We've got to, actually get into the actual dungeon properly. So. There we are. With that cute little puzzle finished, we are through. But we're still not quite into the actual dungeon yet. This is still like the beginning rooms. You heard me right. Rooms. Plural. Okay, so, let's dip in our lantern here. We're gonna need it a few times here. And as you can see, there's a locked door there. We're gonna have to go through here. And get our first key. But, got some, those bug things from, like, the mummy here. The lantern will keep them away from us, thankfully. Alright, we're free to go. And in we go. We're still not in the real part of the dungeon. Got a lot of these mini skeleton thingies here. There and... man, a lot of you little guys. Thankfully, these guys are not infinitely spawning. Even though it seems to be the case, they are actually quite finite. Okay, it didn't exactly mean for that to happen, but it happened nonetheless. Alright, here we are! This is where the real dungeon starts! Ooh, four pole lanterns! And it looks like it's ripping off the Ocarina of Time! With those four lights gone, we ain't gonna go much farther in. One is staying still, huh? Let's face them like a regular Poe and You don't really look like a regular Poe. However, these Poes actually do count towards the Poe count. And I now have 17 souls! Get the other three and I fulfill the this requirement for Giovanni's quest. And we can actually find the others here. Forget the Scintavilia? I guess we have to. I smell dead people. Alright. Other guys seem to go all over hell. Like two went through that way. Let's first go through here first. Opening up a little stone staircase. Alright, let's see what's going on here. Okay, interesting iteration of the bubble. Come on! What the hell? I totally missed! Get him! Okay. So the first Poe went up, huh? But first, let's see what's behind that wall there. Oh, hi! It's a Gypto! Mmm, jerky. And 20 rupees. And another small key. Sweet. Alright. I hear stuff up right upstairs there. Alright, let's see here. Can we go up as is? Yes, we can. Oh, rats having weird gnawing noises. So, right through here. Looks like to be our next Poe! Yep, I see the trail, and I see the Poe trying to hide among these lanterns. Get rid of these little guys first. Alright, you're next. Gnawing on ghosts somehow. And with that, that is Poe number two. Okay, with nothing else in this area, let's go back and rotate the room back to where it once was. And I want to get something before we move on. A couple of somethings, really. Yep, there's a flame going back to its original position. Yeah, as you can see, there were a couple of treasure chests surrounding that doorway there. So, back to human. And let's, no, not do that, do this. And with this, we get... Ah, Piece of Heart! That brings us up to, I think, 9. And, up we go! Alright, can I make it through here? Yes, I can! Let's take care of these bubbles here. Oh, come on! Missed! Again! And this is, must be the map. Alright, let's get rid of this guy here, because he's just hiding behind the chest! Alright then, and with that, let's continue on, shall we? Now this is gonna take us on basically one circuitous route. A big circuitous route at that. Alright. Look out for those little sandworm things and giant spikes. Wow. Well, there goes that guy. Didn't think anything would happen. Well, I didn't really think I hit him at first. Alright. We want to bring this thing right over here for important stuff. Over here? There we are. Got it. Thought I saw something over there. Oh well, let's just take this chain, shall we? And bring it over. We need that block there so we can actually get it all the way up. Or else we will not have enough time to actually make it across here. Thankfully, it won't actually crush us. And a fire bubble, huh? And you? Come on. Gotcha. And that looks a bit better, and right in here is... the compass! Okay, then. Got this thing here. And we can actually push this thing, looks like this way. Okay, that is the way there. Forward. And let's face this Gypto here. Oh, boy! Get off! Here we are. Didn't want to get hit by that gigantic sword. And in here is the key, I believe. Yep. Always thankful I get the that much more money from the Gypto. Okay, then. So... well, I hear one of the Poes. And more of these little skeleton midgets. That wasn't too bad. Oh, there's more. Oh, ow! Come on! Get up, get up, get up! I'm gonna. Ow! He hit me regardless. Well, he got the first one. Eh. Got out of it just in time. Oh my god, get off of me, get off of me! Well, that worked in my favor. This looks suspicious. Let go of the button by accident. Hi, buddy! You're number three! And I'll take your soul as well! With that done, let's continue on. So, what is in here? Looks a little, before straightforward. Another key! Alright, suddenly got dark. Uh-oh. We're suddenly slow. Cannot see anything, so you know what that means. See exactly what's going on. Wow, even Minda's freaking out about it. Alright. Whoa! Skeleton rats! That was fun, and, there we are. Get off of me! Let's go back to human then. And this brings us to oh, the central room. And that lights up number three. Careful not to fall off, otherwise you're going to have to go through all that stuff again. So it brings us to a familiar type room. What is that sound? Is that one of those little sand thingies? Alright then. We're gonna have to, oh, there's something behind here. What is it? Money! Always nice to see. Alright, let's see here. Have to keep on pushing it, I guess. Yep. I was right. Hey, is there more stuff behind here? Just in case. Oh, yep, there is a bit more stuff. Okay, that's getting to that door there, which leads us back onto on the lower level. So we don't really need that. So yeah, let's continue on with going backwards. Thanks. I needed that very much. Thank you. I needed that reality check. That was the last reality check you're ever gonna give me. That's for sure. Okay, just keep on pulling this thing till we cannot bring it back anymore. This brings us to a stamp! Midna stamp! Surprise Midna! So we're gonna have to go around here, it seems. Well, hi! Or do we? You know what? I'm gonna try to... Wow! Well, I'm gonna drown in sand then. I resign to my fate. Alright then, with that stamp gotten, let's pull this back once more. And let us actually stand at the middle of that so we can actually get across there. And just a little bit of a wait. And across we go! Okay, I think I see something ahead that is cause for some concern. Let me just bring out this thing here. Because we got a Stalfos! So, this is pretty much like our, if you guys remember my playthrough of Link's Awakening, you're gonna have to do this. Bombs are the only way to make sure that they stay dead. And, I think these are gonna give us some more bombs. Now that I think about it, we can use bomb arrows against those things to instantly kill them without a fight. Let's do that. Alright then. Anything else in here? Money. Hearts. That's always nice to have. And I guess more bombs. Yep. I think that's about all we could get here. Continue on. Okay. This room. This one had a lot of people stumped for a while. This game actually has a solution right here. Basically, we're gonna use wolf form to find out what to do here. So, looks like we're gonna hit the this one here, and then the one at the very end. With the lantern. But just to show you what happens when you fail this. Yep, we have a little army of these little mini foes. Stop poking me! Okay then, now I'll do the real solution. And this should bring us to the last Poe, because I think I see familiar territory in the map there. So, which one is which? Hello! Oh yeah, this is Ocarina of Time written all over it! So, which is the real one? Gotcha! But the only one that actually that turns bright is the real one. And I should have locked onto the real one there. Oh! I didn't! Okay. I just randomly let go. And that is pwn number 4! We got 20 pwn souls! Well, let's follow this flame back to its destination here. Okay, up, I see a shortcut there. And its name is Clawshot. And we're already halfway done with this dungeon! Yes, only halfway done. But thankfully, it's a fairly linear excursion. And a loading screen for the next half of the dungeon. I'm gonna try to do a finisher on this bubble here. Ha ha! Missed entirely there. Bye! Okay, nothing to do in this room just yet. And we cannot get to the boss key right over there, either. So, we're gonna have to go the only way we can now. Alright, so we got a big corkscrew room. Ow! Kind of, kept my legs in working order there. So, use this lever to have this thing go up and down. Okay, so we're gonna have to find a way through there. Easy enough. A little passageway back there. And a small key is our prize. Let's see what else is around here. Okay, doesn't look like anything else around here. That's, I believe, where we came in at, but I just want to do a cursory check here. Nope. I think we may have got everything, but leaving no stone unturned. Okay, I believe that brings us back up, so let's go back down, shall we? Step by step until we finally get to the friggin' bottom. Okay, which brings us to this kind of room here. I think wolf form is actually gonna help us out here. And it will. Because we got those rats again! Get rid of these friggin' rats so we can actually work here. Yep, thought so. You can actually only get rid of them when you're, when you're using your senses. Okay, let's see if I can't remember how to get through this little thing here. I might be a little backwards because, again, this is I am basing my memory off of the Wii version. I guess you're sick of hearing that excuse, huh? But nonetheless, we made it! Huh. Few rats have climbed on board, huh? Not today, buddy. Get off! Don't need ya! Anything, any skills here? A heart's always good. Okay, let's just revert back to human. And, yeah, just make our way through this little hallway here. Uh-oh. Got these, ow! Could have done without that! I see Uku over there. You know what? Let's just go say hi. Whew! Free at last! Gracious, you're that nice fellow who helped me out the other day! How nice to see you again! Well, I didn't help you in the lake bed temple. Sorry about that. Well, now that we found each other again, let's stick it together for a bit, hmm? I'll be right with you, so if you want to worry about, just let me know. Now, let's go through here. And make our way further and further in this death trap ridden hellhole. Huh. Try to see. I don't think we can actually go that way just yet. Ah! Bad time to pick up a skull! Alright, I see a couple of stuffles waiting in the wings. Huh. Guess we're gonna. Hey! Get off of me! They just fly off. Alright then. Ah! Worth it! And I got plenty of oil on me. Okay, can't go through that way just yet. Okay, let's go through here and... thought so! Worth it! Alright, now that thing is open. I had to blow myself to Kingdom Come to actually get it open. You're welcome. Alright, and hops. Yep. Lazy climb. Lazy climb. Get away, frickin' bugs. And jump away. So this brings us to... gigantic circular arena with a spur just north. Let's see here. Nothing suspicious. Hmm. Oh, I think we did it bad. We got a living sword or something. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, hi, big guy. Goat man. Headman. Thanks for attacking! Now you are a scary fella! Let's see here. Keep track of this guy here. Oh, okay. Yeah, I gotta... Oh, I wanted to do a mortal blow. Come on, big guy. Let's nail him with the... There we are. There we are, got him. Got him stunned and... Hey, I can't do a mortal draw on him? Okay then! If that's the way you want to play it... There we are, let's just hack and slash him. You're not too tough. Ew. I'm just twisting myself left and right here. Come on down, buddy. Come on, you are gonna die sometime! Come on, big dude. Oh, you wanna play this game again, huh? Come on. This is kind of uncomfortable here. Here we are, gotcha! Demonic howling? You really know your demon face bag. But we got him! Now, our prize is way over here, and I gotta admit, this has gotta be my favorite item in the game. I don't know why, is the spinner here is, to me, it's just, it has so much potential in it. The problem is, it has so much missed potential. So, it says you can allows you to float. That's not entirely true. As you can see, I hug the ground pretty well here. And I don't really go very far. What it actually does. See these patterns on the wall here? You can attach yourself to them. That's how you float. I mean, it could be used for so many other things. Sure, there's... outside of this dungeon, there's... like, only a few... uses for this thing. But I was so happy when the... Hyrule Warriors... gave it another, it gave it another purpose. I didn't mean to do that. Let's just go over here and try that. And up we go! And we got a little playground to screw around in. Ow! Well, I wanted to get that thing over there anyway, whatever it is. Bombs? nearly full on regular bombs. Cool. Thanks, I actually wanted to get over here anyway. That was a happy accident. Money! Okay, then I think that's all the ones on this part here. So, let's head on up. So. Up. Just a sec. Wasn't really seeing what, keep on blowing myself up with those things! And then here is... a piece of heart! Up! I see you! 10 rupees. Not exactly worth it, but whatever. Now to have some real oh, crap! That could have gone better. Ah, come on! Freaking spike bars ruined my fun. Alright, maybe I should get through right now, huh? Going the wrong way! Don't wanna drown! Don't wanna drown! Wanna go this way! And another... Oh, hi there! There we are, I did blow myself up that time. Bye! And it here is... a stamp for the letter D! And let's finish this off, shall we? We are so close to the end! Wow, only 45 minutes and we're very nearly done with this place if I don't screw up. And we're almost near the rupee limit, too. Okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of scouting here. Yes! Made it! Whoop! Oh! Almost... did not see that guy! And here is our boss key! Now let's get... No! Up we go! Oh, we're gonna die. I don't know how I screwed that up so badly! And, here's the other little... thing to do with the spinner. Turn little mechanisms. Really rusty old mechanisms. Okay, let's just... there we are. Let's just make our way up, shall we? I think right around here would be a good place to drop off. And, actually, no, I see a lip over here we could have better access to. Nope, I was wrong. You know, I never really noticed that there's like a low humming when the spinner is actually working. There's like a little... Come on! What do I need to do to actually get on there? Go all the way up? Does not look like to be the case. There's a fairy there. You know what? I'm gonna grab her. Now just take this and take her. Don't really need the potion, really. It's... Now let's try to get onto this dickbag platform. Oh! I could have easily used the spinner to do so, instead of die again! That's the third time I've drowned in sand! There we are. Alright, and over we go! Come on! Wow, this is the slowest I have ever seen this thing go. Come on! Can I make it over there and not drown for a fourth time? Thank you! So, what do I need to do to get on there safely? Got it! Wow! I am such an idiot. And just keep on spinning this thing, and then eventually... a big old spiral comes out of the sand. And follow the spiral all the way up! To the boss room! Let's do this thing! And what is this big thing? Could he be the funnest boss in the entire game? Hey, Zad, what's up? You still live! How astonishing! No wonder they call you hero. But this is a truly bittersweet reunion, truly. For I fear this is the last time I will see you alive! I swear I am not hitting the button. Giant Evil Sword, check. And I'm guessing reanimated the skeleton. Reanimated skeleton, check. Ladies and gentlemen, Twilight Fossil Star Lord. First off, run to the top here. All right, then, with that thing gone. It's time to- Ow! Thanks! Appreciate that! Thanks for doing that. So, We're gonna have to go for a spine! With the spinner! This is the only significant thing you can do with the spinner. But don't think that the subsequent strikes with spinner are gonna be so easy. Because he's got these little undead warriors pop off the ground to block your way. You can easily dispatch them to to make a path for yourself. I suggest you do that to make your life a bit easier. Come on! And boom! We need to hit it one more time! Yeah, that went well. And now he has a second layer of those dead warriors. Let's get down there again and thanks for the pinball, guys. Appreciate it. Can I make it? Yes! Little tap! That's gotta be the funniest way I've ever seen anybody just like take care of the Stalwart here. Just a little slow pink! Alright then. Make our way up and play victory. Unless something absolutely crazy happens. Oh shit, something absolutely crazy happened. Ladies and gentlemen, the second phase of Stalwart. This is gonna be the most fun part of the game here. Chasing the thing on a high-speed spinner section, listening to the second boss battle theme from Ocarina of Time. Dodge his fireballs and you will eventually catch up to him. And slam him against the wall! And now you have your chance to attack him. You know what, I'm just gonna go regularly because I saw another strategy in which we could actually use a mortal draw on the sword there, which is his weakness, but it wasn't really doing anything for me. And it looks like we didn't have enough to go to the next part of this phase. Because I was too busy fiddling around trying to get a mortal draw. Wait until he fires. Oh, what? Really? Well, okay, that was a bunch of crazy steps there. Bouncing around. There we are! Alright, let's catch up to him and wait until he actually fires those things off. Here we are. 2, 3, 4. Oh, come on! This is gonna be bullshit all the way, isn't it? Did I say the spinner had two shadows there? I think there totally were. like just spin around as he's climbing this wall. It's admittedly it's a slow spin. And boom! Come on! There we are. Should be enough to get us to the next portion. Yep! All those spikes are coming out of the woodworks. These guys are not going to be a problem once we get to Star-Lord himself. Really, dude? Really? At least we were at the very start of the trail there. They're beautiful. And boom! Come on. There we are. Got him. And let's also get our 10th heart container! Or rather, yeah, now 10 heart containers up there. I was right! Alright, let's see what we have up here. It's a giant stone snake lady with a bunch of chains on the ground. I guess the mirror is right under there. And we got some Shadow Beasts to contend with. But not three this time. But five! Okay, we gotta get three of them together there. Take care of this guy. This guy here. Now, let's get these guys together here. Okay, got... okay, let's take care of this guy here. Easier to take out two at once than three. Crap! Take care of these two. This guy on the other side. Then we can take care of the those two that somehow didn't stick together. Come on. Got Gotcha! Got 5 hearts laying around. We don't need them. We just need to climb up the snake lady. And now to spin this last mechanism. Okay, then! Giant obsidian chain with chains all around it, and, oh, that looks not good. I'm guessing the spirit toilet is not supposed to look like that!
A dark entity lurks in Twilight. It houses an evil power. You who are guided by fate, you who possess the crest of the goddesses, hear us. At the command of the goddesses, we sages have guarded the Mirror of Twilight since ancient times. You seek it, but the Mirror of Twilight has been fragmented by mighty magic. That magic is a dark power that only he possesses. His name is... Ganondorf. He was the leader of a band of thieves who invaded Hyrule in hopes of establishing dominion over the Sacred Realm. He was an even known as a demon thief, and even the evil magic wielder.
I could not read that for some reason.
But he was blind. In all of his fury and might, he was blind to any danger, and thus was exposed, subdued, and brought to trial.
This text is going way too fast for me to read out loud.
Yet. By some divine prank, he too had been blessed by chosen power of the gods.
Ooh.
abiding hatred and lust for power turned to purest malice. Perhaps that evil power had been passed on to Zant.
You're just now figuring out where Zant got his power? It's far too late.
Only the true leader of the Twilight can utterly destroy the Mirror of Twilight, so Zant could merely break it into pieces. Once broken by magic, the Mirror of Twilight became fragments, which even now lie hidden across the land of Hyrule. One is in the snowy mountain heights. One is in an ancient grove. And one is in the heavens. You who have been sent by the goddesses, you should be able to gather the three pieces. But you must be prepared, for a dangerous power resides in those fragments.
Clean up your mess, got it. Well, I think that'll do it for now. So if you like this one, hit the like button, comment on it, and if you want, subscribe. So until next time, see you later!